What's up, guys? Welcome back. Today I'm going to be giving you guys my full 2024 Monster Jam season standings predictions, my annual video. We'll see how I do this time. I've done all right over the past few years, predicted a few tour winners right. Let's try to go 5 for 5 though and get all of our tour winners right at least. And behind them, we're going to be giving you guys spots 1 through 12 in the stadium, spots 1 through 8 in the arenas based on standings and what I think is going to happen. So we're going to go ahead and get right into it with Stadium Tour East. This one really hard to predict. A lot of talent in this tour. It's very top heavy. I think there's 6 guys who honestly have like a realistic shot of winning it. I think those guys are top 6. The bottom half, I don't really think has a chance. But those are also some really talented drivers. So at 12, I've got Jester, Matt Pagliarulo. At 11, I've got Lindsey Reed, Lucas Stabilizer, who's stepping in to replace Cynthia Gauthier. I have Nick Pagliarulo and Kraken in the 10th spot. In 9th, I have Ryan DeSharoon and Shaker, a great driver he is, but just a really talented tour, and I think that's about basically where he's going to finish. Jamie Garner and El Toro Loco. He had a bit of a breakout year last year. He's always been a really solid driver, but he was coming off of a down year or two with Overboard, and with El Toro Loco, he seems to have found a bit of his groove. And then John Gordon, Bad Company, I'm gonna have him in 7th. Really talented driver there, but I just don't think he's gonna do better than anyone in the top 6. So in 6th, I've got Cole Vinard in the Black Pearl, and that feels like I'm putting him a little too low, not giving him enough respect. But again, there's a lot of talent on this tour and it's top heavy, so I'm gonna leave him at 6 for now. Also, I wouldn't be surprised if he does much better because it's an even year, and Cole Vinard over the past few years has done a lot better in even years. For example, 2020 he finished like 2nd in the tour. 2021 he had a down year during the COVID year. 2022 he had another really good season, and last year was a bit of a down year in terms of how well he usually performs. I think he even finished below Jamie Garner. So anyways, in 5th it's Tristan Englund-Digichard making his Stadium Tour debut. I think he's going to have a really good season. We've seen his talent, and he's going to showcase that. Bryce Kenny is going to take 4th because he's really consistent throughout all 3 competitions. Top 3, your 3rd place, if I taught the Duke and Megalodon, again, just a really consistent driver. But I don't see him getting higher than Tom Mentz, who I've gotten 2nd. He's entering his final season, his farewell tour, and I think he's gonna have a great season to end it off. But I don't think he's gonna be able to outbeat Tyler Manning and Gravedigger, who was extremely good last year. All right, so let's move on to the Arena Championship Series Central. In 8th, we have Zombie Frank Krummel. In 7th, we have Alex Barden and Stone Crusher, who I believe is a rookie. We have Brianna Mahan, Scooby Doo in 6th, Brent Talachka, and Just Get Her Done in 4th, Michaela Talachka and Megalodon in 4th. Sorry. Brandon Talachka in 5th, Fernando Martinez in 3rd, and El Toro Loco, who's also a rookie, Jamie Sullivan in 2nd, and then Weston Anderson and Gravedigger taking the tour win. It's going to be really hard to predict these rookies, by the way, because I don't know much about them. So, yeah, I could be way off on some of them. Kurt Kramer and Ramunition in the Arena Championship Series East, I think, will finish 8th, and 7th is going to be his teammate Mark Hall and Raminator. 6th, I've got Angelina Rock and Megalodon, who's a rookie, Chad Tingler and Overboard in 5th, Cody Socia and Dragon in 4th, Zach Garner and Wildside, who I still think deserves a shot at the Stadium Tour in 3rd, Chris Anderson and Gravedigger in 2nd, and another driver who I think deserves a shot at Stadium Tour is Armando Castro and El Toro Loco, who I think is going to take the championship in that tour. In the Arena Championship West, I've got Brandon Trevino and Massimo Rottweiler in 8th, who's a rookie, Ashley Sanford in her 2nd year in Megalodon in 7th, Devin Winfield, the rookie Velociraptor driver, in 6th. MJ Solario in El Toro Loco in 5th. James Calhoun, who's a rookie, in 4th. MJ Solario is also a rookie, by the way. And then Dalton Widner in Jurassic Attack in 3rd. In 2nd, I've got Tony Yokes in Thunder Roars. And the winner of the tour of the West Arena Tour is going to be Brandon Vincent in Gravedigger. And then your final tour, Stadium Tour West, I've got Joe Foley in El Toro Loco in 12th place, but I do think he's a really solid freestyler, and he should improve a lot. In 11th, I've actually surprisingly got Jim Kohler in Avenger, again, just a really good driver, but these guys are all pretty consistent above him, and it's just hard to predict. I've got Mike Christensen in 10th, because he had a really solid season last year, and I look for him to improve. And then same with Chris Kohler and Monstrum. I've got him up to ninth, which, I mean, that does not feel like I'm giving him enough credit or respect, but I just don't see him getting above some of these guys. Or I do see him, I could see him, you know, getting a top eight finish. I'm just not predicting him to, but again, I could see it. Soldier Fortune, Caleb Budd is going to be eighth. She had a bad first weekend, so that's why I kind of have her a little bit lower. And it was close enough to where something like that would affect my prediction. So David Olfer, I think in his first Stadium Tour year with Velociraptor, will finish seventh. Colt Stevens, reigning world champion, should have an improvement year up to sixth in Thunder Voris. Corey Rummel and Megalodon, I think the top five are really solid drivers. Corey Rummel's going to get fifth, I think, right behind his good friend Bari Musawar and Zombie, who's opened up with an incredible two shows with a freestyle or two freestyle wins, a skills win, a racing championship, and an overall event. So he's going to finish fourth. I think Adam's actually going to get third. Adam Anderson is going to get third, only behind Camden Murphy, who I think is just going to have a really outstanding year. But I just don't know if I can choose him to win the tour over Ryan Anderson yet. So I've got Ryan Anderson still winning the Stadium Tour West. So let me know if you guys have any predictions or hot takes for the 2024 Monster Jam season. Let me know if you disagree or agree with anything I said. And yeah, that'll just about do it. Thank you guys for watching. Subscribe if you're new. Like the video. Drop a comment. And follow me on Instagram. Thank you so much for watching.